What's up, everybody? This is MMA Rant. I'm coming to y'all today with another video. But like always, before I get started, I want to say thanks to all the subscribers. Thanks to everybody that's been watching my videos, everybody that's been leaving comments. And one other thing, subscribe. Now on to my rant. I'm on here today about the rant on Jose Aldo Jr. Jose, whoever gives a fuck. Bitch ass Aldo Jr. He's been on the record. He's been reporting, of course, like always, ever since he got his ass chin checked at UFC 190. I ain't even going to say because I'm tired of talking about his bullshit ass. But I've got a rant on his ass right now. Ever since he got his fucking chin reconstructed by Conor McGregor, he's been on Twitter. He's been on Brazilian talk shows, Brazilian news reporter interviews. He's been talking major shit about Conor McGregor. How are you going to talk shit about somebody that just whooped your ass? I'm going to tell you right now. If I get my ass whipped by somebody, I'm not going to continue talking shit to him. I'm going to leave the motherfucker alone. I'm going to give him his props. And I'm going to leave his ass alone. You know? That's what you do. Man to man, imano imano, eye for eye. You get your ass whooped in a competitive fight, you leave the motherfucker alone, you give him his respects, and you go about your business, okay? But this fucking Brazilian gringo, stupid ass, bitch ass Jose Aldo Jr. has been still talking shit. He's been talking major shit about Conor McGregor being on damn steroids, being on the juice, being on PEDs. Whatever you want to call it. And you know something? I don't even blame him for that. Because you already know when he was in his fight with Conor McGregor, he was looking like a scared ass bitch across the cage. Looking like he fucking was about to get an ass whooping by his dad for disrespecting his mother. That's what the fuck he looked like. He looked like he was about to go into jail or into prison for raping a little kid. And I hate to get that graphic on here about some shit like that, because that ain't no shit to play with. But that's how Jose Aldo Jr. looked that night when he fought Conor McGregor and he was standing across the cage from him. That's reality. That's what he looked like that night. And guess what? The way his ass got countered and fucking dropped after the third punch was thrown, if that was me, I would have probably fucking accused his ass of being on fucking steroids too. Because he hit his ass with a punch that he didn't even throw any force into. He like just threw that shit out there and connected on Jose Aldo's little weak ass chin, glass chin, and fucking dropped his ass. Jose Aldo fell to the ground like somebody holding a hot ass frying pan without any oven mitts on. That's what the fuck he felt like. He felt like somebody dropped that shit. And then Conor McGregor got on top of his ass with fucking hammer fist in his ass. Like he was fucking beating some damn dough or something. Like he was trying to get the lumps out of some damn dough. So he's been on the record saying that Conor McGregor's been on steroids. That he's on steroids. That he's on fucking PEDs. You know, he's trying to explain that basically Conor can be on the steroids and still not get caught with him. And he could get, he's talking about how he got to Los Angeles a week before. He got the damn juice pumped out of him and all this type of bullshit. Like, what the fuck are you talking about, Jose? What the fuck are you talking about? I don't know if to take this shit serious about him, about what he's saying or not. And I'm not talking about taking him serious as far as Conor McGregor being on steroids. I'm talking about taking him serious as far as the process and the steps and how you can mask being on steroids. Because from what I've heard, I've heard his bitch ass has been on steroids. I've heard that a lot of those Brazilian fighters over there in Brazil are on steroids. Or on PEDs, I should say. That's what I've been hearing. So for him to kind of break down how you can be juicing, and then a week or so before the fight, you can mask the shit, it's kind of had me scratching my head wondering if Jose Aldo Jr. is the one that's really doing steroids or doing PEDs. Because he kind of broke down this shit on how to fucking get this shit out of your system or how to mask it. So he might be fucking telling on himself. It's almost like having a little child or having a little brother or your son, you know, and you know he's been stealing or doing something wrong. And you kind of trick him and you ask him, hey, if I wanted to steal something or if I wanted to do something, how do I do it? And like a fucking idiot that Jose Aldo is, or like how you could trick your little brother or your little son or your little daughter into telling you how to do it, they will go ahead and explain to you how to steal or how to do something. And that's because that's something that they do or something they've done before, you know? So that's how Jose Aldo Jr. has been acting on these allegations and reports of Conor McGregor being on damn PEDs. And then Jose Aldo was talking shit about his upcoming fight at UFC 200, talking about how, I'm fighting for an interim belt, but I don't give a shit about that belt. This is basically what he's saying, you know, but I'm going to do what I got to do to get one step closer to getting the championship belt or getting the fight with Conor McGregor. Jose Aldo, when it's time to fight Conor McGregor, and that's if you beat Frankie Edgar, because honestly, I don't want to see your lame-ass fight Conor again in a rematch. Because when your ass get knocked out in 13 seconds, who gives a shit about seeing the rematch? But just for GP, general purpose, let's say you beat Frankie Edgar at UFC 200. And then it's time to come back to face Conor McGregor and do your little press conference with him again. Are you going to come out on stage with that fucking interim belt? Are you going to come out on stage with the belt that when Conor McGregor had his interim belt, how you were making fun and talking shit about him? With that interim belt? Are you going to come out there with that fake-ass belt? Are you going to come out there with that fucking fake-ass UFC championship belt that you can get on UFC.com, I believe for $450? I hope you come out there with that belt. Because all that shit you were talking about with Conor McGregor being the fake champ, he's got his fake-ass belt. Guess what, bitch? If you beat Frankie Edgar at UFC 200, you're going to be the one coming out there with a fake-ass belt. But guess what? That fake-ass belt suits you perfectly. Because I'm going to give you your respect to this since you've been an undefeated champ for 10 years in the UFC. But guess what? Ever since your ass got knocked out by Conor McGregor, you've been acting like a fake-ass Jose Aldo, a fake-ass ex-champion. And guess what? Your fake-ass personality and your fake-ass attitude is going to go with that fake-ass belt that you're going to bring out there to face Conor McGregor with. And that's if you beat Frankie Edgar. Because personally, I hope Frankie chin checks your ass and you fall like a hot-ass bag of potatoes again. That's my rant, y'all. Subscribe. Leave a comment. Let me know what y'all think. Hit the thumbs up button as well. And like always, subscribe.